Have you ever felt uncomfortable or even a little anxious about marketing your business online? Well, stick around because in this video, I'm going to be talking about how to overcome your fear about being visible on social media. Hello, hello, I'm Sharon Lee of fearlesspursuits.com and you are watching Fearless Empower Tube. This is the place to be for entrepreneurs who want to grow their business online and work on their mind. So today, I want to talk with you about this really uncomfortable feeling of fear of marketing our businesses, because it's something that is really kind of epidemic. That was something that I felt for a long time. It was really uncomfortable for me. And here I am standing in front of you, in front of the camera, and I still choke. I still stutter on my words. And I don't know that I'll ever overcome it completely. So that's okay, because all I have to do is just coach myself through it. But I'm going to coach you through how you can actually do something very similar, even though you may never actually get through feeling uncomfortable and anxious or fearful, because I still do. But I'm standing here doing it. So generally speaking, when we're talking about procrastination or the inability to actually achieve our goals, it generally has everything to do with fear. It's kind of a no-brainer, right? Here we are in the digital age, and we realize, especially because of Gary Vee, thanks Gary, you know, that book called Crush It, we know that we're supposed to be posting on social media several times a day. I believe Gary says on LinkedIn, we are now supposed to post between 7 and 15 times on LinkedIn. That's crazy, right? So this is a combination of written posts and pictures, images, sharing other people's videos, and creating our own videos. So we've got Reels, we've got TikTok, right? There's so many different ways of getting out there online, and the social media platforms are just making it harder and harder because of what they're favoring in their algorithms. Using Instagram as an example, we know that Instagram is favoring Reels, and that's really difficult for some of us who may be introverted, and we don't want to get in front of a camera, let alone being creative and actually creating something that people would be interested in watching, right? So there's all sorts of complications about getting out there, putting ourselves out there so we can stand out and be the chosen one, the expert that people want to hire. So we have to really deal with our anxiety. We've got to cope with our fear and have the tools so that we can actually step out and do the things that we need to do. So what we're fearful of is judgment of ourselves and other people. I usually judge myself. I feel like I'm going to look like an idiot. And sometimes I actually do. And so what I do is I make fun of myself. And it's a way that I cope. And it's easy for me to do. It's something that I've always done, and it helps me because I realize that I've got a greater goal for my business, and that fuels my passion to actually move forward rather than always doubting myself, right? So when we're thinking about this fear comes from all sorts of things. It comes from judgment of what other people will think, a judgment of ourselves. I'm not good enough. I'm not smart enough. I'm not doing it right. I'll look like an idiot. So, you know, there's all kinds of dialogue, this internal dialogue that we're having, and we think somebody else looks better, and why don't I look as good, right? So this is us constantly comparing ourselves. This is that comparisonitis that we have to deal with, and women are the worst with comparisonitis, and we have to stop it. And we know why this is the case. It's because we do see perfection out there, and it makes us feel inadequate. And that's the bottom line. So what is the solution? The first thing that we have to do here is we have to identify our thoughts, just like I was doing, the thoughts of feeling inadequate, like I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough, somebody else is better. Those are your thoughts. Let's identify them, okay? And now what we have to do is we actually have to change our identity. We literally are assigning our identity to our thoughts of, I'm not good enough, right? So your thought was, I don't necessarily want to get on video or do a reel because I might look like an idiot. I'm not good enough. So your identity now is, I'm not good enough. So we have to take a look at what our thoughts are. And then we have to see how we're really assigning and attaching our identity to our thoughts. And this is a major problem. So how do we solve this? So what we're going to do here is we're going to talk about how we feel when we are really comparing ourselves to other people. We're going to take a look at how we feel when we're saying, I'm not good enough. My information isn't good enough, and we're judging ourselves. So obviously, you are you. You know you better than me. And you, as you're listening to this video, you're able to identify your own fear and the issues that you have for standing out online and doing the things that you need to do to grow your business. So let's take a look at those thoughts that you're having. How do they make you feel? Now, we realize that if you're watching this video, more than likely you have some sort of fear that you have to overcome. So I'm not really talking to the person who says, well, Sharon, I don't actually have a problem with standing out online. If that's you, then why are you watching the video? So we're really talking about the people who are dealing with some kind of anxiety and fear around getting out on social media and really pushing out the content that we need in order to be seen. So this is where we have to take a look at the feelings that we have when we're talking to ourselves like that. And what we want to do is we want to switch it around. We're changing our identity. And our identity now is of a person who is helping. So here you are thinking that you're a person that isn't good enough. You're thinking that you're a person who doesn't know enough. Right? So what if you were a person who is helping? How would that feel if you could say something like that to yourself? I need to create content. I need to do a video. I need to do a reel because it helps people, right? So what we're doing when we're in this fear mode and feeling anxiety and not wanting to do this is we're in the ego. We're in our own mind and we're thinking about ourselves, right? We're not thinking about who we're helping or their problems. And this is the biggest problem of all, because ultimately, as a professional, whatever it is that you do, you're a coach, you're a consultant, you're a freelancer, and you want to help people. You want to sell something and make some money, but ultimately, you want to sell something and help somebody out of a problem and into a solution. So the way to do that is to really switch your mind out of your own fears and be thinking about them and their problems, right? So this is you changing your identity and saying, okay, I need to get on camera and I need to do these things and I'm just going to do it, but who am I? Am I a person who is fearful? Am I a person who is full of anxiety? Am I a person who is comparing myself and I'm a person who is not thinking I'm good enough, smart enough, know enough? Or am I a person who is helpful? Am I a person who is knowledgeable and willing and able to help people? This is your new identity. And let's talk about how you feel. So when you are saying to yourself, I am a person who is helpful, how does that feel? When now you're standing in front of a camera, close your eyes and visualize yourself standing in front of your phone. You're making a video or something, or you're going to do a live stream. And you're thinking, I am going to help somebody today. I'm going to bless somebody with my knowledge. How does that feel? That probably feels very empowering. So now you're in a stronger place. So now you say, I am a person who is knowledgeable. Now, if that doesn't sit well with you, then maybe you're looking at it in the wrong way. Are there people that are more knowledgeable than you? Absolutely. Are there people that are more knowledgeable than me? Absolutely. But that does not mean that I do not have knowledge to help you. Do you have knowledge more than your clients? You probably do. And in that case, you are a person who is knowledgeable. Leave it there. Don't go to the other place of, are there people more knowledgeable than you? You don't need to go there. That's none of your business to start looking for problems. You see, this is the way our mind works. Our mind is always looking for what's wrong. We're always thinking something is wrong. And in fact, there is nothing wrong. You simply need to switch your focus into a new identity and realize you are a person who is helpful. You are a person who is knowledgeable. Now what we're going to do here to overcome your fear of being visible on social media is to practice. That's right. You literally have to practice. One of the things I suggest my clients do is to just record themselves and just practice it over and over and over. That's if they want to do live streams or get on video or do reels or something like that. And don't worry about the haters, because eventually there's going to be some haters. Someone once told me that I have an awful voice, and another person told me I was butt ugly. And that's a really terrible thing to say to someone you don't even know, who is really putting themselves out there, right? So what we have to do is we have to know that those haters will come. They're just trolls and they need help. Let's just face it. So what we have to do is we have to practice. You can actually practice in your head. You can actually visualize you doing the process of creating the video, going on live, grounding yourself so that you're ready to actually help somebody. Remember, that's what we're doing here, is we're getting out of our own head, out of ego, and we're thinking about how it is we can help people. So let me ask you this. Who do you prefer to be? What is your identity that you prefer to have? Is it one of somebody who is fearful, always doubting and comparing themselves? Or do you prefer to have the identity of someone who is helpful and knowledgeable? This distinction will help you move out of fear and into helping people. And once you help people, that's when the money starts to roll in. All right, so I have a video for you. If you enjoyed this video on mindset, you might like the other video I have for you. It's the steps to changing your mindset. And I'll link it here above and in the description below if you're really interested in working on your mindset. If you got any value out of this video, be sure to like the video. That really helps YouTube algorithms to show this video to more people and support me in my channel. All right, be sure to subscribe to the channel. This is Sharon Lee. I'm out.